Defining currency denominations. So in this video, I'm going to take you through how we can add your currency denominations and define what ones that we accept and that we take in our business. So if you're in a cash business, you may want the tellers to count the denominations either during transactions or just at the end of day for closing. So how can we do that? Let's go down to our drop down over here and we want to select denominations. Once that's brought up all of our denominations that we accept, we can now add, delete, edit any of these that we need to. So already in our system, we have Canadian $100 bills, 50, 20, 10, 5, and then $2 coins and $1 coin and all the coins that we can accept. We also have euros and we have Mexican and US. So let's add a new currency. Let's add a new currency denomination. So up on your toolbar, we click on new, and we need to type in the currency code. So for this example, we'll use Australian dollars. So AUD is the code, and we can click on tab. Once that brings that down, it's bringing up Australia dollars. And now we need to enter in the denominations that we take, that you want to take. So let's say there's a $100 bill. We can hit enter or return, or we can click on save. Once we do that, you'll see that the $100 has come down into the already defined column. So we know that we can now go on to the next. So it's already been saved for us. If we're unsure about what denominations that Australian dollars actually come in, we can click on this button to the side, look up in Wikipedia. Once we click here, it takes us to the Wikipedia site for Australian dollars. And then on this site, you can see scrolling down to the right, it actually shows us what banknotes that they take, that they have, and what coins that they have. So we can use this information as we add in our denominations in our system. So we've already done the $100 bill. So it's also showing that they have $50 bills. And then we can hit enter or return, and 20, 10, and 5. Let's say that we also want to take the coins, some of the coins. So let's do the $2 coin. We now need to check the box is a coin, and then enter. And we also will take the $1 coin as well. If we do want to take anything that's less than a dollar, the system will automatically assume that it is a coin, so you don't need to select it when it's under a dollar. So now we see that we've already defined all of these down here. Now we need to get back out of the screen. So how do we do that? We don't click save because the system is showing zero as denomination and there is no such denomination. So we just need to click cancel because they've already saved the defined denominations to the left. So we click cancel and you'll see that they have all been saved come through. I'm going to just open up the $100 bill again. So let's click on edit. And let's say, for example, they're very rare and we don't exactly know what they look like. So you want all of your tellers to be able to compare it to a picture or to know that they have the right one. So again, on this Wikipedia website, there just happens to be some pictures of the bills. And I just want to show you that we can actually save a picture into our system so we can show people. So we're going to get this picture up and we can right click and we can copy the image. Then when we go back to our currency, in this big square right here, we can command or control V, which is pasting the picture. And now we have that underneath our $100 bill. And we need to just save that, so that saves. And you'll see that that image is now attached to the $100 Australian bill. So you can always reference that. Let's open it up again. I just want to show you one more section. You can also put a URL, so a website, in this box right here that can take you to any kind of information about that bill as well. And then once that's saved under here, you can now click on the go to URL and it will take you to that website, that URL that will give you that information on that bill. But we're not going to do that. I just want to show you that is possible. And that is how you add your denominations.